we could do an intro after if you think it, or we could do it one before. It doesn't really matter, as long as we probably say something, not just randomly appear and go, "Hey, we're watching a thing. It's on HBO." That kind of thing.
Hello, everybody. Welcome, welcome. Today, I am back with Cooper Amuse. Cooper, I'm visiting your channel as well.
Hi.
We are going to be watching The Last of Us live action
trailer
type thing. Trailer. Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
It came out
live action today, which is the 27th of the 9th. We're going to point that out in Australia because that may be wherever you are, that could be somewhere different.
Yes. So we decided we'd sit down and watch it together and put our lovely reactions up on the camera for you guys to see. We were just having a quick discussion before, and Cooper was talking of her about her concern over how HBO was going to do it.
Although, straight up, I just want to point out that if HBO, excuse my language here, fucks this up like they did with Game of Thrones Season 8, I'm going to be pissed!
I have seen a few things on Twitter, and there has been good reviews for it.
For it or for the trailer? Because I'm hearing great things about the trailer. People are really excited, but that's what trailers are. They're meant to get you excited.
That's true. That's true.
And also, like, totally, look, I haven't seen it, and I don't actually know who's in it, like, specifically who's taken cast-wise. But from what I can see, either the chick who played the awesome lady in Game of Thrones, she was, like, super young, she was the kid lady of some place, is in it, and she's either going to be Joel's daughter or she's going to be Ellie, and I don't know which is which. And then Oberyn Martell, which is Game of Thrones character, which is who is playing Joel, it's like, oh my god, it's the Game of Thrones characters coming together. But that's where the concern comes for, like, right. You brought them together, but don't screw it like you did Season 8. Yeah. Also, another thing popped into my mind before, spoiler alert, I guess, if you haven't played the second game or seen the second game like I have, Joel, you know, doesn't have a good time. And the way that Oberyn Martell dies is, you know, can be a bit similar, perhaps, into Joel's story coming forward.
Yeah, and then you get quite, like, it's really well known that video games really get the short end of the stick, and
when they're made into movies or TV shows?
Movies. They just can't seem to give the same immersion that you get when you play the game.
Yeah, so Last of Us, and this is just the first trailer. There's usually two or three trailers in total. But it's scheduled for 2023, and I think it's like a late 2023 for us, not an early one. It'll be on HBO, not HBO Max, which means I think there's some sort of link between binge and HBO, but not binge and HBO Max. All right, so we're going to watch the trailer. We're going to try not to say anything during the trailer. It's going to be hard. I will react, but I won't go into a spiel. And then afterwards, we'll try and pull out the business of what's in the trailer and what it could be leading us towards. 3, 2, 1, go!
The roses have faded, there's frost at my door. The birds in the morning don't sing anymore. The grass in the valley is starting to die, and out in the darkness the whippoorwills cry. The darkness is falling, the sky has turned gray. A hound in the distance is starting to bay. Alone and forsaken by fate and by man. Oh Lord, if you hear me, please hold my hand. Alone and forsaken by fate and by man. Oh Lord,
this is your chance.
You hear me, please hold my hand.
Oh, that shot.
Please hold my hand.
You keep her alive.
Hold my hand. Please hold my hand.
And you said everything right.
understand.
I'm really excited. The music at the start, perfect. Perfect choice. Very, very Joel, because he plays the guitar and he's very rustic in the way he would sing his songs and stuff. It's perfect. Obviously, the lyrics are awesome as well.
I'm excited to see the full makeup of those
clickers. Yes, seeing that one shot of the clicker, I'm like,
hearing that noise took me straight back into the
game. To the game. Yeah.
And I was with Joel going, shh, don't you?
Yes. And I'm like, be quiet, don't say a thing. I really wanted to have a look again at the clicker makeup, because when you first look at it, like, it for a moment there, it looks really terrible and like really funny, because it looks very brightly colored for a clicker. That's all to me. It just looks, when you first see it, and because you only see it for a very short, you know, not split second, but you see it for just a sec, and it's just like, hang on a second, that was definitely a clicker. How good does it actually look? I get why it's very orange around there, and I get the gray and stuff. And with the remastered version, it does very much look like that. But that could be residual hair from the human that's still hanging about on it.
No, but I mean, think about it though. It's basically like when The Last of Us first came out, there was this whole big thing about, you know, how it could actually happen. Like the creators had made it based on something that could actually happen. It was a virus from a plant that kind of mutated and stuff like that. Mm. So there was the ability, that's one of the things that I really enjoyed about the game, was the fact that it was based on something that could actually happen. And you know, so yeah, it's based off of plants, so by rights they'd have like little bits and pieces of that kind of stuff on them anyway.
At the beginning also, there was that firefly symbol that they were painting over, and they were very being watched and had been chained up and everything by what was remaining of the government or the people who were running the joint and stuff. And it's like, yep, that was pretty much what it was like.
I wonder if it's going to be kind of like not one that's kind of run at the same times of the game, but maybe one of what happened during the middle.
Well, okay. From what I can see in the trailer, it looks like it's actually going to follow the first game. I think there's a part in the trailer where we see someone looking back at Joel, and I think for a moment, is that his brother? But I can't connect that image to the one that you see where he's driving away from the town with his daughter. The brother's there as well, Tommy. And Tommy had long, like in the video, in the trailer, it does look like there's a dude there that has longer hair.
That guy with the long hair that had the shotgun shooting in, definitely Tommy. It has to be Tommy. It can't not be Tommy, because it looks like Tommy.
We're definitely seeing, prior to the clickers and all that becoming the norm, we're seeing the beginnings of the virus and stuff. I think we're also going to see some of Ellie's flashback, where that's her story that happens that you can play, that happened between game one and two, but it's not happening between game and two. It was the prequel to game one, really. I think you're going to see that, because at 48, you can see two people on a carousel, and one's Ellie and one is another person. And number 50 for that one, if you're looking for that person. And that's a really important character or person to Ellie, that kind of gives Ellie the gung-ho kind of attitude, you know, doesn't give a shit what everyone thinks. She'll say what's she'll be super honest about everything, you know. She's not gonna sugarcoat shit, all that kind of crap. I think getting those flashbacks are really going to kind of build Ellie's character the way that they wanted to continue to do after finishing game one, by bringing that DLC where you could play Ellie before she goes on her journey with Joel. The reason she goes on the journey with Joel across to the Fireflies, you know, all that kind of stuff, which isn't a spoiler. 104, there's an actress playing a character who I don't know, and I haven't looked up who she's meant to be playing.
I know her. I've seen her in something else.
She's in quite a few things.
She was in a comedy of some sort.
Yeah, but I don't know who she's playing, and I can't think of what character she might be playing.
She looks like she's playing some sort of, there's a whole lot of military people around her. I wonder if she's playing somebody from the government or something, maybe?
Yep, maybe she's the people that are tracking Ellie and Joel down. She's part of the group. She could also be a researcher, actually, and just, like, a hardcore, like, captain researcher or something. I don't know what's higher, a sergeant or a captain. I think they've got some really good action shots. There's lots of running. There's always lots of running. There's lots of fighting.
They've, they've pandered to the audience by giving them the clicker shots.
Yeah, for sure.
A lot of gamers would have been looking for.
Yeah, to see how they were going to play out the actual monsters or the baddies in the game. Well, the non-human baddies, I would probably call them now, because they're not necessarily human anymore. So I think there's quite a bit to like about it. But that's bloody hell, it's a trailer. That's the whole point. You're meant to be super excited because the trailer's going to show you all the best bits, but in not sequenced order, so that you don't exactly know when things are going to happen. But that they'll happen.
Shows, what is it they say that shows all of the best parts of the movie?
Yes, like in the trailers for games and stuff too. That it's always like some of the best parts of the game being played, and like the rest of it's a lot of grind and stuff. I just hope they don't have too much like filler, like with characters we haven't met before that they're not going to spend time with. If they're going to bring characters in to give it a bit more beefiness or whatever, those characters need to be given a sizable amount of actual personality and meaning to the story, not just, hey, here's a random person you run into while you're traveling to the Fireflies and you'll never see him again and they're just a side glance.
Do you realize how many side glance people you come across in The Last of Us?
So many. Although, the ones that we haven't seen any evidence of in it was the two people they met, the father and son, on the way. We didn't see anything about them. I don't think they're cutting them out. I think they're probably going to save them either for another trailer or at least, you know, they'll be in the show.
There is quite a bit of, not regularity, common where movies take out smaller characters to merge them into other ones.
Like, yeah, give their role or their importance to another character to make them more important stuff too. So, because of what happens between the father, son, and Ellie and Joel, like what it really gives Ellie, I'm hoping that it's still in there, even if they don't have those characters, they still need to have it there because that's a lot of Ellie's initial, excuse my language, oh shit, this is going to be a lot harder. Like this is real life. People do this kind of stuff all the time. Like, you know, this could happen to everyone I care about, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, so either they keep them in and we just haven't seen them yet, or they're going to give
them. Yeah. Because it is such a big part of the game, they might want to say, like you said, save it for another trailer.
But it looks like essentially HBO is trying to do the same thing it did with Game of Thrones, but this time it was a game, not a book. Follow the same story. The story's actually done, so there's no way they can screw this up unless they're actually aiming to change things.
Which I hope they don't, because it's so hard with video games. We are a very picky bunch, man.
We are.
It takes a lot to get us to be, I want to say sated, but it's hard to say that with you in the room.
What are you talking about? You can say that word.
So we like it to be just as we want it, kind of thing.
Yeah. We're the same way the game runs, we want it the same way too.
Exactly. And it's hard to have the same, as I said at the beginning of the video, it's hard to have the same immersion in a game that you get on a movie, like the same.
In a TV show or a movie.
That you get in a game. Because you're actually playing that character, you're actually making those decisions.
Yes, so I'm looking forward to this. It says 2023, but given everything, like, I'd say later 2023, Australian, like, spring 2023.
Quite a lot of good new stuff coming out. Like, I just finished watching Arcane this holidays.
Ah, finally.
Finally, yes. Oh, my God. I binge watched it in 2 days.
It's so good.
It is so good, but it's not coming out until, what, 2024? 2020.
Yeah, it's a while still.
Yeah, no, they at least 2 years when they first said the announcement. The announcement was just after they finished season one. Mm. You know, so I'm like, ugh. But they have announced The Witcher to start at the end of on Christmas Day. So
it's so exciting. Oh my God, yes. If y'all are interested in watching us react to some more of things of Witcher or other TV shows, let us know in the comments, because I don't mind doing this kind of stuff. It's kind of fun.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's always nice to do content with Coop.
Oh, stop it, you. You know I get my jollies off when I hang out with you. So looking forward to Last of Us.
See the jokes live. You can find us on Twitch.
Yeah, you can. And look, just link down below to Vic and all of her gear or her content platform. Well, most of her content platforms, because there's a lot.
You do it too.
They're on my thing. If they're on my channel, then it'll be on there and they can look at it.
Gee, this is such a professional video, isn't it?
Look, man, hashtag pro content creator. I was going to say pro streamer, but that's about right anyway. So thanks for joining us. But link down below to everything for Vic, so go check her out. Streams on Twitch as well. Thanks very much for joining us. If you want to see some more React content, give us a hoi. Down in the comments below, or, you know, jump in that Discord, y'all. Tell us yourself in there. Or comments, probably is just putting in the comments. Links down below, everything with Vic. And, looking forward to The Last of Us. Let us know what you think of the trailer. Anything you're excited about? Have you played the games? Are you looking for a direct connection, or you're hoping for a bit extra?
Mm-hmm. What she said.
Otherwise, we'll see you guys later. Bye!